Hello everyone, I Professor Pardeshi AR. Today here we are discuss about the fourth chapter of Environmental Engineering 2nd BE Civil, that is low cost treatment methods for the rural areas. In that, our topic is nothing but the classification of oxidation pond. So first classification is nothing but the aerobic pond, okay, in which the whole activity or a decomposition process is carried out under the aerobic condition. Second classification is nothing but facultative pond, in which the decomposition or oxidation of the organic matter is take place under aerobic as well as anaerobic condition. And last one is nothing but the anaerobic pond, where the decomposition or the oxidation of the organic matter take place under the absence of the oxygen. So let us discuss one by one. So first is nothing but aerobic pond. It is also called as the algae pond because of the algae, it produces the photosynthesis process. It produces the oxygen, which is utilized the bacteria for the generation of new bacteria and produce carbon dioxide. And this carbon dioxide again use algae, and by the photosynthesis process, it again releases the oxygen in that wastewater. This process is continuous. So this process is under the aerobic condition. That's why this aerobic pond is also called as the algae pond. Okay. It consists of shallow depth of the earthen basin to treat the wastewater by the natural process. That is the photosynthesis process. The aerobic condition is maintained in that aerobic pond, in which the organic matter which utilize as a food for the microorganisms and which produce the carbon dioxide, which is utilize the bacteria algae for the photosynthesis process and produce the water, and in which the organic matter which is utilize the bacteria which generate carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is utilize the algae which produce the oxygen in that wastewater, and this oxygen can be utilize the bacteria to produce new bacteria cell and CO2 in a sewage. This process is continuous. That's why the aerobic condition is maintained in the aerobic pond. Second classification is nothing but the facultative pond. Okay, it is a combination of aerobic as well as anaerobic pond, and in which facultative bacteria is present. It having the depth from the surface is near about 1 meter to 1.5 meter, and having the particular zones in that facultative pond. First zone is nothing but the top zone, where the aerobic biodegradation, that is the decomposition of the organic matter with the presence of oxygen, is take place, and the photosynthesis process is done at the top of the zone. At the middle zone, that is nothing but the intermediate zone, where the aerobic anaerobic zone is there and decomposition is done by the facultative bacteria. This is the combination of both aerobic and anaerobic bacteria is there. That's why it is called as a facultative bacteria. And at the bottom of this facultative pond, the last is nothing but the bottom zone, where the decomposition is done in the absence of the oxygen. That is the anaerobic zone is there. Okay, this is all about the facultative pond. And third classification, the diagram shows the facultative pond, in which the upper surface, where the aerobic zone is there, at the middle facultative zone, and at the bottom anaerobic zone is there. At the surface, there is a aerobic zone where the bacterial algae symbiosis is there. Due to the photosynthesis process, the aerobic condition is maintained at the surface or a top of the pond. At middle, that is the facultative zone, both aerobic and anaerobic process is done. But at the bottom of this pond, the anaerobic zone is there, where the decomposition is done directly in the absence of the oxygen. So third pond is nothing but the anaerobic pond. It is just situated below the facultative stage, and if there is a no free oxygen, that is called as it is a putrefaction. Okay, and in which the bacteria using the bounded molecular oxygen from the compound nitrogen oxide or sulfur oxide. Okay, this bacteria does not utilize the free oxygen molecules from the surface or anywhere, but it utilize the oxygen from the bounded molecular compounds, chemical compounds. Okay, in which the organic matter which produce the acid forming bacteria, and lastly it gives the methane, that is the stable product. Okay, this is about the anaerobic pond. So next method is nothing but low cost method, that is the aerated lagoons. Okay, they are the deep oxidation pond and aerated continuously by diffuse aerator. Okay, it having the larger depth as compared to the oxidation pond. That's why to maintain the aerobic condition, the air diffuser are inserted or mounted in that lagoons. The principle of aerated lagoons is based on the microbiological process. That means the degradation or a decomposition of organic matter is take place by using the microorganisms. It required less area and less detention time as compared to the oxidation pond. Okay, next point is nothing but the treatment process of the aerated lagoons. Okay, these are the earthen basin of the depth is about 2.5 to 4 meter and oxygen is introduced continuously by the surface aerator by means of the diffuse aerator. Diffuse aerator are inserted on a surface by using the permanent foundation on which they are mounted, and continuously oxygen is introduced in a aerated lagoons in which the sewage in the lagoons are pass through the grit chamber without any primary treatment. Okay, there is no any primary treatment. Sewage is directly discharged into the lagoons through the grit chamber. It acts settling cum aeration tank. That's why these aerated lagoons behave as a both settling tank or aeration tank, which having the detention period is near about 3 to 5 days, and the efficiency is near about 70 to 95% of BOD removal. The diagram shows the aerated lagoons where the diffuse aerator are fixed on the permanent foundation, and this is surrounded by the berms, that is the earthen basin is there. So method of aerations are nothing but the floating jet aerator, second floating surface aerator, third fixed place surface aerator, fourth motor driven submerged aerator, and last fifth injection compressed air through the submerged diffusers. So let us discuss one by one. So in that first one, submerged diffused aerator, it consists of the diffuse grid located inside the lagoons, and second floating surface aerator, which having we or which remove the efficiency 80 to 90% of the BOD with the retention time with 1 to 10 days. Diagram shows the floating surface aerator. These aerator are floating on the surface of the sewage in the lagoons, and which introduce the oxygen in that sewage to maintain the aerobic conditions. So advantages are nothing but its initial cost is less as compared to the other ponds. Then it is suitable for the middle size of the town or cities. So no need of to provide primary treatment units. We can utilize directly aerated lagoons, and it required less production of the sludge. Hence the disposal of the sewage or the sludge is minimized. It having the low sensitivity towards the toxicity, and it produces less odor. There are some disadvantages. First one is nothing but it requires a larger area. That's why it is suitable for the middle size of town. It cannot be suitable for the cities. So second one is nothing but it required the energy or power for the aeration or diffuse aerator are there. That's why it's required the energy or power. That's why it is costly, and it required the continuous surface aeration, and it is sensitive to the cold climate. These are the advantages of aerated lagoons. So next point is nothing but the difference between activated sludge process and aerated lagoons. So activated sludge process provide the fertilizing constituent, while the aerated lagoons used as a wastewater system. Activated sludge process where the sludge obtained with the minimum amount of oxygen, where the aerated lagoons, the continuous supply of oxygen is required from the surface aerator. In ESP, it required the less area as compared to the aerated lagoons. The ASP is biologically active system, whereas the aerated lagoons pond of the higher depth to treat the wastewater. And ASP, that is the activated sludge, mix with the raw sewage to treat where the aerated lagoons, the sewage in the lagoons after the grit without any primary treatment, these are the inserted or discharged into the aerated lagoons. And 6 point in ASP, the treating the sewage or industrial waste by the bacteria and the aeration. But in aerated lagoons, ponds with the artificial aerator by the oxidation of the waste water by the diffuse aerator. This is the difference between ASP and aerated lagoons. So next point, the difference between the oxidation pond and aerated lagoons. So oxidation pond requires a larger area, that's why it is suitable for the rural areas, where the aerated lagoons required the small area as compared to the oxidation pond, and it can be suitable for the cities area. Next point, in oxidation pond, it having the shallow depth and it is the earthen basin which is open to the atmosphere, whereas the aerated lagoons is a having the deep depth pond. The depth about oxidation pond is near about 1 to 1.5 meter, which is shallow depth, and aerated lagoon is very deep, having the depth about 2.5 to 4 meter. The hydraulic retention time for the oxidation pond is about 20 to 60 days, and it is for aerated lagoons 2 to 4 days. For oxidation pond, there is no need of the longer retention period, but aeration lagoons having the need of shorter retention period. This is all about the oxidation pond and aerated lagoons. So our next point is nothing but the phytoremediation, okay? A process in which direct use of the living green plants to remove the contaminants present in a soil, sewage, sludge, surface and subsurface water, it is called as a phytoremediation. That means we can remove the toxic material or contaminants from the sludge, sewage or a waste water by using directly green plant. For example, Canna indica plant we can utilize for this process, and it is efficient use of the green plant to the removal of toxicity from the wastewater or a sewage. This is very important technique to treat the sewage or a wastewater in a natural way. So application of phytoremediations are, first one is nothing but for the degradation, in which green plants which having the chlorophyll may be able to perform the degradation in the rhizosphere, and which some plants in which they are responsible to take the toxic compound for their nourishment and make the sewage or wastewater clean or toxic free. So second application is nothing but to extraction, okay? It is able to separate metal contaminants from the wastewater. And third is nothing but the containments and the immobilization. Okay, in that non-bioavailables are the removed by the transport, and some plants are used maximum quantity of water which can extend their roots, which is helpful to control the water, groundwater contaminants. That's why the some plants which are utilized the more water, and their roots are moving towards there, and which reduce or control the contaminants at the depth of the sewage. The advantages of phytoremediations are, it is suitable to treat wide variety of the environmental contaminants. By using this technique, we can treat the all type of waste which is suitable and which is eco-friendly. It is a better option to in a place of the mechanical cleanup methods. Okay, we can replace the mechanical treatment by using the phytoremediation technique, and it is eco-friendly technique which is not hazardous for the environmental or a human being. But there are some advantages or limitations of this system or technology is there. So first one is the thing, but it require the larger wetland and required the long time for the treatment. Because of the natural process is there, it required the longer time for the treatment of the sewage, and required the wetland which create the bad noises or a bad foul gases is there, and bad aesthetic views is there. Okay, it produce the fly noises and mosquito breeding in that particular area due to the wetland. And the toxicity affect the survival of the plant. Some plants are which are not capable to extend with the toxicity, and these this can happens with these plant, they can withstand with the toxicity or affect the survival of that particular plant, and it is limited to the depth of the root of the plant. Okay, this is the disadvantages of phytoremediation technique. So next point is nothing but the root zone cleaning system. Okay, in that the grits and floating materials from the sewage or wastewater can be removed, and the sewage is passed through the bed of the soil, in which the effluent, that is the wastewater, get percolated through the bed to the roots of the wetland plant. Okay, and these, the bacteria and fungi which is mounted on the, or which is stable, or which is situated on the roots of the plant, these are responsible to oxidation process aerobically. Okay, the bacterial algae symbiosis or a fungi symbiosis is there, which maintain the aerobic condition to decompose or oxidize the organic matter and aerobically, and roots of the plant acts as a biopump. Okay, for the bacteria and fungi, the roots of the plant is behave as a biopumps and to obtain the non-pollutant clean water, which produce the clean water which is free from the BOD and toxicity. So advantages of the root cleaning systems are nothing but it having the low operational cost as compared to the other treatment units. Next one, it is eco-friendly system because of the wastewater can be treated by using the root of the plants and the fungi and bacteria. Okay, that's why it is eco-friendly system. No fly nuisance is there, no power required to maintain or to operate such a systems. The maintenance cost is also very low, and it develop the natural culture, and it remove the BOD is near about 90%, which is very efficient technique to treat the sewage by using natural way. So that's it for today. Next part we'll continue in our next lecture. So thank you.